Yes, students, we have discussed the diffusion or compressibility of the gases. Now, students, we will discuss the main point, freezing. What do you mean by the freezing? Freezing is the solidification of the liquid. What do you mean by the freezing? The transformation of the liquid into solid state is known as the freezing. And as we all know, the water freezes at 0 degree Celsius and it converted into the solid state. Now, what do you mean by the freezing point? The temperature at which the freezing of a liquid occurs, that is called the freezing point. But students, if we talk about the non-volatile liquid, if we dissolve the non-volatile liquid in a pure water, what will happen? It lowers the property of the freezing of the liquid. The pure water, the freezing point of the pure water is a 0 degree Celsius. If non-volatile liquid is dissolved in it, it lowers the freezing point of the water. Next is the evaporation. Student, have you ever seen water in a flat dish is left exposed to the air? What will happen after some time? The water disappear. In other cases, you can see the shallow pond, water also disappear during the summer season, mostly. So now, water, where has the water gone? Think. Water will go in the atmosphere. So, what do you mean by the evaporation? The process in which water change into water vapor. That is called the evaporation. If we can say that, the, what do you mean by the evaporation? The process by which the water change into water vapor below its boiling point and also exposed to the air also, and by applying heating but below the boiling point, that is called the evaporation. Now there are the many factors which affect the evaporation. Nature of the liquid. First is the nature of the liquid. Second is the temperature. Then surface area of the liquid. Wind speed, humidity. Now we have discussed the, we can say that the wide dish, flat dish. You can see the surface area is more. If surface area is more, then the rate of the evaporation will be fast. If surface area is less, then the rate of the evaporation will be less. If we talk about the temperature, if we apply the temperature in higher temperature, the rate of the evaporation will be increased. And by decreasing temperature, the evaporation, the rate of the evaporation will be decreased. Next is the wind speed also. Wind speed, if we increase the wind speed, if wind speed is increased, what will happen? The rate of the evaporation will be increased. If wind speed is decreased, then the rate of the evaporation will be decreased. If we talk about the humidity, what do you mean by the humidity? The water vapor present in the air during the monsoon season. You take example of the drying of the clothes. In monsoon season, drying of clothes takes time because the water vapors present in the air already. So, higher the humidity, lower the evaporation. So, students, they are the factors which affect the evaporation. Tomorrow we will discuss again all are the factors which are responsible for the evaporation in wide state, and think the example of the all these factors which affect the evaporation.